already talked before about some sort of squat variation, whether it be the kettlebell, whether it be the holding sandbag or plate squat. All of those same things come into play, but we're gonna start using a bar now with a front squat and a back squat. Ideally, the movements don't change, it's just where the bar is gonna be held that's gonna change. So again, we wanna be shoulder width apart, toes slightly out, maybe 30 degrees out. They can be straight forward if you feel confident in that, but usually your glutes fire a little bit better when they're 30 degrees out. Hips, squeeze, nice tall posture, and then what we're gonna do is try to bring those ribs down to our pelvis again to tighten up through the core. And then in both of these, where we hold it is gonna force our shoulders to be pinched back where we have ideal position. Remember, anytime that we do these activities, as we squat down, the first thing that we're gonna do, release the hips back, engage the glutes, and then we sink through the knees. Sink, 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 sink through the knees, as deep as we can get, and then we come back up. Now, we're gonna go ahead and address the bar over here. So if we address the bar, the first thing I'm gonna show you is the front squat, because it helps us to make sure that we keep an upright posture. When we do the front squat, don't try to hold the bar. It's much tougher that way, and most people don't have adequate wrist flexibility to hold it that way. So what we're gonna do is we're just gonna find the smooth of the bar. We're gonna put our index finger right on that smooth. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna reach underneath and raise our elbows at the opposite side and sit it on a shelf that's been created by our shoulders. Again, if I let go, it would sit on a shelf. And that's what we wanna be able to see and understand, is that the only thing that my fingers are doing is locking it into that shelf. So again, I'm gonna lock underneath, elbows high, step back, and you can see it's sitting on that shelf and my fingers are just locking it in. That's all they're doing, and I got plenty of wrist flexibility in order to do that. Now, all the same things that we just talked about, not gonna reiterate them, making sure that the hips are back, knees are sinking, and just get that depth that we wanna get as deep as we can. Elbows high, and then drive up out of that squat. Front squat. Great, because it engages my back and gets that strong with the proper posture. Second thing that we're gonna do, which is the more advanced, is gonna be the back squat. Now we're gonna set it on a shelf in the back, and that shelf is created by my scapula or my wing blade. Okay, there's a little shelf on it that we wanna sit in, so again, grab about shoulder width to thumb width apart from that smooth, get underneath it, and what you're gonna do is make sure that you're ready to lift the bar off there when you start. But right now it's sitting on that shelf on my shoulders, okay? So again, we don't wanna be too high up around the neck. We don't wanna be too low where it comes rolling down. We want it to sit right on that scapula, and there's actually something called the spine of the scapula there. Again, everything else that we already talked about in the squat, nothing changes. Release the hips, sit down through the knees, deep, 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 and then drive up out of that hole. Same time, making sure that you do not allow that back to roll with anything that we do. We want this, we want that proper posture with that flat back.